Hey guys, Neptune here. In today's video, I'm going to be taking you guys around the 2014 Jeep Cherokee Trailhawk. I had this car as a loaner vehicle for about a week. Down in the description will be links and spec information and all the pertaining things to that. You guys can go check that out down below. This is the 2014 Jeep Trailhawk. It was replacing the Jeep Liberty, which in my opinion is a very forgettable car. The Trailhawk is the highest trim amongst the Cherokee line. When it was introduced, the trim order was the Sport, the Latitude, the Limited, and then the Trailhawk. Obviously the Trailhawk being the highest. You get that really cool Trailhawk badge, as well as the 4x4 as standard. All the other trims came with front wheel drive as a standard, but could be upgraded to a 4x4. Being the standard, you know, having the front wheel drive or the 4x4 as a standard, it makes the Jeep Cherokee Trailhawk an actual off-roading vehicle. Like you can actually use this car off-road. I didn't actually use it off-road, but I did get to drive around through some piles of snow, icy snow, and it got through it just fine. So having that, I think the Trailhawk mixes the best of both worlds. And I will be mentioning that in the driving portion of the video. It is definitely competent off-road as well as on pavement, but it's not exactly fast. It has a V6 in this trim. It's 271 horsepower, 239 pound-feet of torque, and it's lugging 4,500 pound SUV. So you won't feel very quick. It makes a lot of noise when you rev it. Again, I'll be showing that off in the driving portion, but you can overtake on the highway with ease. Fuel economy is rated at 19 city and 25 highway. With my week of ownership, I was seeing around 25 miles per gallon, which is not terrible considering what you're getting in the Trailhawk package, but it's not the best. These are some night shots. This is the front end, which actually the newer generation has changed the front end of this car, but I think that this generation actually still looks a whole lot better. The newer Cherokees look more like the Grand Cherokee in the front, but I kind of like that the LED running strip on the top with the actual headlight being below it, as well as the fogs. If you do buy a Trailhawk, should you buy one and you want a Jeep, I think if you really want a Jeep and you want it to off-road, the Cherokee is the best of both worlds. You're gonna get a car that's good in regular driving, and you're gonna get a car that's good off-roading. And I'd also like to mention currently, as of today, in my area, the cheapest Trailhawk is selling for $17,995 on AutoTrader, and that is the cheapest in 50 miles of my home. So I think for that price, you get pretty good off-roading capabilities and not many things that can compare to at this price. So from this point, we're going to go ahead and show you guys around the interior at night. This is the whole center stack, and we're going to move on to the driving portion now. Drive here. There's street driving. I'm already in drive. Got my seatbelt on. And regular street driving, it's quite relaxed, quite comfortable. It's not the best handling vehicle, which is why we're over here by the lake shore, where there's not a lot of cornering or high speed roads. This is not really the type of vehicle you take on those kinds of terrain. This is more of the off-roading kind of vehicle, being the Trailhawk. You can drive the car quickly, but it does take a lot here. So right now I'm just going quite slow. The only way to get it up to becoming a speeding vehicle, or a quicker responding vehicle, I should say, would be to put it in sport mode. and just mashed the gas, which, as you see, it's not the fastest in the world. I don't know how long that was, but I'm only going 40, and that was about 80% throttle there, which I don't want to go too fast on this back road here, but this is where a lot of pedestrians walk around and walk their dogs and go for jogs. But anyway, as I was saying, the handling on the car, it's responsive. It's meant to go off-roading, but in reality, it's a very comfortable vehicle. These seats are actually quite amazing. The headrest itself feels like a pillow, and I honestly love these seats. If I wanted something that wasn't gonna hug me, which this vehicle is not the kind of vehicle you need to be hugged in, these are the kind of seats I would want. These are great seats. All the luxury features, you have heated steering wheel, you have your heated mirrors, all of the little luxury options. Unfortunately, the only real downside is for your passenger. Your passenger will not receive, at least as far as I know, in this trim. I have to slow down here because this guy in front of me is going way too slow. Your passengers will not receive power seats. The passenger only gets a regular bucket seat with regular manual controls. The rear seats are actually quite roomy, surprisingly roomy, and they're also the same material and partial leather and partial cloth, which actually turns out to be quite comfortable for the backseat passenger. Moving along, we're gonna try to go over to the drive over here, LSD, and we'll pick up some speed a little bit. Unfortunately, back here, there's not really any corners, but like I said, this is not the kind of car you drive. It's not the kind of car I think that you would buy if you want to go spirited driving. You would probably have to upgrade yourself from the Cherokee to getting the Trackhawk and not the Trailhawk. Being the Trailhawk, this is more, as its name implies, for the trails, for off-roading, but also allowing you to, you know, have a little more relaxed feelings while you're coming home from those trails. Let's turn over here onto Lakeshore Drive. Failed to use my signal there. So, picking up speed. You can pick up speed quite easily, but overtaking, you'll need a few seconds to get up to speed here as I mash the gas. So you can see it just revs really high and doesn't really want to, you know, give you that power. All the specs and everything will be down in the description. Like I said, you guys can go ahead and check it out further. In conclusion, would I recommend this? I think if you like Jeeps, like the Wrangler, if you were looking at a Wrangler and you really wanted a Jeep, I think that this, personally, if you live in a city, is the better option. But if you're like if you live in the countryside or the suburbs, and you live like, for example, somewhere in Arizona where you have a lot of off-roading trails, or like Utah, Montana, these places out where you have more options to go trailing, then I would say get the Wrangler over this. I would think that it would be a lot better for those kinds of things. If you wanted to have a vehicle more for the occasional road trip and the occasional trailing, but you didn't want to sacrifice your comfort, I would honestly say this is a great option. I don't think many other vehicles come right as a full package with all of those kinds of features, at least not in its class. I mean, you could probably get maybe the new Mini Countryman that you can buy like an off-roading kit for it. A lot of SUVs have off-roading kits now, but this comes as a complete package, which I think makes it a great choice. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like, a thumbs up, subscribe, check out my Instagram. Again, all the specs will be down in the description below. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Peace.